Hi there, here's mental coach Otto from the Tennis Academy Ball Planet in Magdeburg, Germany. Welcome to another edition of my mental training online program. Last time we began a discussion of self-image, chapter 1 of the book Psycho-Cybernetics by Dr. Maxwell Maltz. Today I'm continuing with the statement that positive thinking should not be towards events and other people, but towards ourselves. What Dr. Mao says, we talked about the self-image last time, says that positive thinking is not working because we channel it towards the outside world, but we should channel it towards ourselves. It's like putting new wine in old bottles. It's something that Jesus warns us about. We can't do this. We can't put new wine in old bottles. The same way as we can't use positive thinking with our old self-image. A self-image or the personality, Dr. Mao says, is the system of ideas, a system of ideas that must be consistent with one another. And that's our personality. And to be happy, we must have an adequate self-image, adequate personality. One we can live with, one we can respect, one we can trust and believe in. And he says that each one of us wants more life, more happiness, success, peace of mind, or whatever else it is that you find important. And the subconscious mind, he says, is not actually a mind, it's a mechanism. It's a goal-striving mechanism that is used to direct the conscious, used and directed by the conscious mind to achieve goals. So the conscious mind puts a goal into the subconscious mind, and the subconscious mind, as a goal-striving mechanism, works towards achieving it. And the most important goal that you should have is your self-image, meaning that you should consciously put an image of yourself the way you want to be, and this should be the goal of your server mechanism. This should be what you mostly want to change and to achieve is a self-image that you can be proud of and happy with. And the server mechanism can also be a negative a failure mechanism. It depends on what we feed it with. If we put an image of ourselves as defeated, as losers, as unable to do whatever it is, then the server mechanism, the goal striving mechanism, takes it as a goal and achieves it. So it's becoming a failure mechanism. And if we put in our minds pictures of success and of what we want to be, then it becomes success mechanism. So it's totally unbiased and it's never discussing what we put into it. It's just like a torpedo. You set a goal for it and it's working towards it without questioning, without asking, without arguing. That's why it should be very important what goals we set for ourselves, and the goals that we set are mental images created by our imagination. Again, visualization. That's the end of discussion of chapter 1. Next time we'll continue with chapter 2. Until then, have a great time.